Guys, welcome or welcome back to my page. I am Santanika and today I would be creating Grace's look from the Peaky Blinders. I absolutely love the show. I mean the whole series, I've loved it. And thereby I've decided to do this look. So just in case you're interested, please keep on watching. First up, we are definitely going to moisturize the face and make it, soft and supple and all makeup ready. So first thing I'm going to use is a face mist by Plum. This is by Plum. And I'll let it dry. After this is done, we are going to go for the moisturizer. I am using the one by Aveeno, but you can use any alternative one or the one that's feasible for you. You can definitely go for that one. So just a little bit and that's it. Apply it so that the skin is moisturized and it's all ready for the makeup look. Basically, I've loved Grace's look from Peaky Blinders. She's so graceful and she's so pretty, and that is what has inspired me to create this makeup look. So, let's get started. We are already started. What's up? Okay, so that's it. After this is done, you're going to use a lip balm. This one's by Siva Mint. I will just suggest, if this is not what you, I'm not like really, really into Siva Mint, but it's okay. I mean, calm chill out type of lip balm. I'm not really a big fan of Siva Mint, to be honest. It's not worth $400. Once this is done, my whole face is prepared for makeup. So obviously, I'll let it set for at least a minute, and after it's all set, we're going to move ahead and put the primer and foundation and the other criteria. Face is all set and now I'm going ahead and putting my primer. This one's by Lakme. You can use any other alternative primer that you like, but I personally love this primer. I've been using it for almost a year now and it just does its job perfectly. So yeah, so let's just apply it. Okay. So I'm going to put it in all the areas that I have issues, especially where I have open pores and, you know, my trouble areas to be more specific. So once that's done, I will just be blending it with my hand. I haven't really used a makeup sponge or a brush till now. So yeah, that is my primer ready face. I would suggest you invest in a good primer, because if there's a good primer, the base of your foundation is going to be strong and it's not going to look cakey after some time. So please do invest in a good primer. And in case my eyebrows are looking a little odd, I cannot do anything, guys. I'm so sorry, because I haven't been able to go out of my house for such a long time because of the pandemic. I can't make my eyebrows. So, yeah, that's it. After this is done, we are going to move ahead with the foundation. So the foundation that I have is by, again, Lakme. This one is Warm Beige W240. So I'm going to just apply it on the areas I require my foundation to be there. I have this funda that once I put my foundation, I blend it quickly, because otherwise it takes a lot of time for me to blend it. It just gets cakey at those points. So once that is done, I will be blending my foundation. Today I'm not using the makeup sponge. Instead of that, I've really found this brush very, very useful and full of benefits. So I thought, let me just stick to this one today. Yeah, that's it. This is the little amount of foundation you actually need, and unlike a lot of people telling you, please put loads of foundation, you don't really need that much. Once the foundation is all ready, we're gonna go ahead and put the concealer. This one's by Swiss Beauty, medium 404 to be more precise. And in case you're new, after foundation you go for concealer, then please let me know in the comment section. And that's the khichdi that we are making for today. Yeah, so now we will simply blend this like a pro. I don't know what has happened today. Everybody is just honking cars and it's so bothersome. Oof. Now we'll just blend it and that is it. all the trouble areas where you feel concealing is required, you just do it and blend it like a pro. Always remember that blending is the key. The more flawless your makeup will look will depend on how amazingly or how well you have blended your makeup. After this is done, we are going to go for contouring so that this part looks more chiseled and your face looks more in shape. So I'm going to use this one by Wet n Wild. So without further ado, let's get started. So this is how you actually contour. Just take the darker shade once, dust it off. Yeah, this is the part you have to make that face. Yeah, you just have to make this face and just... do it to your lower face angle also. Yeah. Nose, you have to be extremely careful because otherwise it'll look broader than it is. Yeah. Can you see that line? Yeah. You have to repeat the same on the other side also. Here, today I will not actually be using a bronzer. So with the same darker shade, I'm just chiseling out my upper angle. That's it. So once this is done, you will use another brush, not the same one, please use a different brush, and wipe off. Yeah, you'll feel that your face has been elevated. Yeah, that just gives your face a more chiseled look than it was earlier. You can make out, make it out that your face looks more chiseled and in shape after you've done this step. Once this is done, we are good to go to the next step, which is a blush. Today, I am not actually applying a bronzer. I'm moving straight to my blush. For the blush, I'm using Makeup Revolution, this shade right here. There isn't any naming, so I don't know what the shade name is. But this one is the blush palette by Makeup Revolution. So, I take the shade, dust it off again. Please remember to dust it off and apply it on my cheeks. So, it gives me the nice little pinky look. Pinky look. Wow. Yeah. You're going to repeat the same on the other side as well. Once it's done, you can dust off a little amount to your nose, but I don't really like that much, so I don't really do that much. So once this is done, you have your nice blush look ready. Now we're going to straight move on and put our lipstick. For today, I'm going to use the lip shade by Lakme again. This one's the Nude Myth. Lakme, this is actually a liquid lip color. And I'm in the shade 17 Nude Myth. I already have my lip balm on, so no need of moisturizing it again. Just don't overdo it, that's the thing, don't overdo it. Grace's makeup was extremely subtle and I want to keep it that way. I don't really want to make it very, very loud. It'll take some time and once it dried up, it'll look more and more the way she had it from Peaky Blinders. After this, I'll be moving ahead and doing my eye. So for that, keep on watching. Taking the shade and again applying it to my crease. Don't worry at all. We're going to dust off all the extra color that you can see. I'll rinse when I take it off. Don't worry. Once this lighter shade is applied, you can see that it gives a lightly browny effect and more awake look to the eyes. I'm going to take the same shade and just with a little light hand, apply it to my lower eye. It just gives a more awakening and a bigger eye effect than this one. And I'll be doing exactly the same to this eye also. Just gently gliding over my eye to give a more subtle and an awakening look. All her eyes look very, very big, but in general, if you see Annabelle, she doesn't really have that big eyes. If you observe her. I don't know why there is so much noise today. It's so difficult. Okay, so once this is done, I will be taking a darker shade, as I told you, this shade, and doing just the outer corners slightly, just a little amount. For that, I'd be requiring a new brush. So I'm taking this one and just go very gentle on it, very, very gentle. You don't want much of it, just a slight darker look. Getting at it. Yeah, that's it. You'll see the difference if you compare these two eyes. This is slightly darker towards the end. Yeah. This is what I wanted. Fine. So I'll repeat the same thing on this eye. That gives a more awakening and a nice night look. So yeah. Once it's done, just exactly at the center of my eye, I would be taking a glitter shade, and with a wet brush, because actually the glitter shade from here falls apart, which is the case for most of the eyeshadow palette. So I'll be wetting my brush and using the lighter shade, means this glittery shade, little bit on my middle corner, and that's it. The eye look is complete. So after that is done, I have taken the glitter shade and you put it on my brush. Where is the brush? Yeah, this is the brush. And that's it. It's slightly wet. Just a little bit. Okay, not supposed to, just drag it to the end, just a little bit. And I'll tell you how I'll be doing the darkening part. As you can see now, this look is created. Now with the, again, same brush with which I had done the darkening, I will be taking that brush and darkening it. I have applied the mascara off camera, and this is the whole look that I have created with Grace's look. I will be putting a picture here. So in case you've liked the video, please do turn the black thumb blue and subscribe to my channel for more such videos. Love, Santanika.